once you decide to address the water system, you're addressing every other difficulty there is. It's not hard to start with mapping, especially since we have this incredible benefit of new technologies. I mean, extraordinary benefit. You can now have a map that shows you where your streets are, where the streams were, where the pipes are now, and how much rainfall falls exactly there. Now that's all available to us. Water always moves in a spiral. If you go out on your wetland in the morning, it's spiraling up. If it's raining, it's spiraling down. This is a sketch of that concept.
And I explain it a little.
I did. I explained it.
I know, but meeting.
And you got it, right?
Yeah.
Okay, they got it.
You don't have to explain.
They got it. I have my 8 principles of water, and about 2 of them are really scientific, and the rest are mine. And mine are like, water doesn't need us, we need water. Life adapts to water, water doesn't adapt to life. Very basic things. And that you don't hear said as part of the discourse, but they're so obvious. Mm-hmm. But what I really want to say is the minute we get together around water, there's something that happens. I mean, really get together. And what it happens because we're all water. And believe it or not, my extra H molecules are not only going around in my body, but they're wanting to connect to your body. And so that's going on. Now, if we're all caught up in cell phones and da-da-da, we can't notice that. And it doesn't necessarily, you won't notice that it happened. But if I were to bring you around a lake and say, leave your cell phones behind, or we go on the beach or anywhere else, you will know it. And part of knowing it is deciding then that we will be in conversation. We will work together. We will not say, you know, my toad is more important than your salamander. And we will not say my tree is more important than your tree. They're all important. And we can love the whole deal. And I can't say it strong enough, like, that this kind of knowledge and mapping of an inclusion has to happen very now, because we have become so fragmented and so fearful of how to protect ourselves, protect our property. Well, I can't protect my property without protecting yours. And you all in the watersheds and here can't protect yourself without protecting the whole system. And if that can become the dialogue and the invitation, then there's a really chance that certain irrational things will just say, that was irrational. We did it 40 years ago and we don't need to do it anymore. We don't need to do this, we don't need to do that, we need to do this. And people always think what I did in China was some kind of miracle, but honestly it wasn't. I could never have done what I did without very, very much of the population on board and without major leaders on board. A man was willing to go to prison. Another man had been quietly studying international wetland research, couldn't leave the country, but he got whatever he could. And he was the only such person in all of China. So it was kind of a miracle, and they believed it too, that I ended up there, and Zhang Jihai. I rarely met a person of such integrity who was in charge of the construction of the 5-year plan. Was willing to sacrifice his entire career to build this park. We made a model, and they sent it around to every community in the city of 8 million. Okay. That's how badly people wanted it. Now, we can do that But we don't do that. You know, I went broke. I was $20,000 in debt. And they gave me everything for free. I did not have a contract. People don't operate that way.
Yes.
Okay? So, you know, it's not because it's a totalitarian government, which is a natural U.S. response. We are just as top-down dictatorial in what we want to make money from as they are in what they feel they need to control their government from, their people. So, you know, don't even do a comparison. It's all sloppy and ill-informed. And so I've known Jeanette for 10 years, and I came here and did a workshop, and one workshop does not anything change. It's fun, you get excited, you get energized, and then, so this time it's like, no, we need a process. The process is flexible, it will respond if something's wrong, but I see it as at least 18 to 24 months, wrapping in more and more people who can have positions of authority. And because you do need, at one point you need permission. A lot of things you don't need permission and some things you do, but there is nothing works so well as something that works. And it works for, that works for people. There is just no replacing of it. And I think that's possible. And even though there's, you know, 60% land coverage and all kinds of, well, I don't see obstacles, I see opportunities. So, so what if all the districts that live around a certain area, and I mean all, so there is no more only this community gets this and the rest of the communities don't get something because they're not as well off or whatever reasons. Like, we cannot have any throwaway populations. That's not okay. We can't decide, oh well. And that's part of a calculation of a corporate world, is the big oh well. Oh well, you know, it's worth it to not do this right because maybe only these many people will die. That in my mind is not okay. And I'm pretty sure, look around the room, there's tons of agreement here about that. And she pulled this out because this is a sketch, but, and I was trying to do a drawing for that all waters are connected for my book. And so.
That's beautiful.